For the last 6 months, I have been using HP Notebook 15 powered by the 10th generation Intel Ice Lake CPU. In this video, I will share my experience using this laptop, the good, the bad, and the ugly, coming up. Hey guys, how's it going? Laptops are in high demand these days, largely because of the current situation, right? All of us are working from home. So if you are looking for a budget slash mid-tier laptop, HP Notebook 15, on paper at least, it looks like a great choice. So I purchased this laptop earlier in the year, about 6 months back, and I've been using it ever since. So in this video, I will give my 6 month review of HP Notebook 15. I will cover all aspects of this laptop and help you decide whether you should buy HP Notebook 15 or not. So this laptop is currently selling on Amazon for around $599, but the laptop prices, they are, you know, fluctuating a lot right now, I guess because of the, you know, the high demand because of the current situation, you know, the whole world is in. So please check out the links that I have put in the video description below for the latest price and availability of HP Notebook 15. Okay, so without further ado, let's get started. HP Notebook 15 weighs 3.75 pounds and it is about 0.7 inches thick. So for a 15.6 inch laptop, this is a fairly thin and light profile. In my 6 months of using it, I have had no complaints with respect to its weight. Although, frankly speaking, in the current situation, I'm mostly at home, so I haven't really carried it around anywhere. For the price, I think the build quality of HP Notebook 15, it's really good. So my unit has a royal silver metallic color with matte finish, and it does a very good job repelling fingerprint smudges. While the body is made from polycarbonate, the laptop feels very rigid because HP has reinforced the chassis with aluminium sheet. I really like this laptop's 15.6 inch screen, which has very thin bezels. So the bezels are matte black in color and they contrast very nicely with the silver color of this laptop. I think HP has done a very good job with the aesthetics of this laptop. There are no cheap gaudy logos or stickers which usually start peeling off after a few months of use. So after 6 months, my HP Notebook 15 has held up really well. Other than some minor scuffs and scratches, it looks almost brand new. This laptop has an LED backlit IPS panel. It's full HD widescreen display. What I love about this screen is the anti-glare matte coating, which helps cut down on glares and reflections. But what I don't like about this screen is its average brightness, which maxes out at around 220 nits. While using this laptop in my home office, which is a very bright lit area, I always have to crank the screen brightness almost to like 90 to 95%. I wish HP had made this screen a little brighter. Now, when it comes to color reproduction, this screen actually does a fairly good job. So pictures and videos, they look bright and colorful, and it's perfectly adequate for watching streaming videos on YouTube and Netflix. So overall, I think this is a pretty good display, not only for media consumption, but also for productivity tasks. So stuff like word processing and web browsing, you will have no trouble using this laptop. Okay, now let's talk about the CPU. HP Notebook 15 is powered by the 10th generation Intel Core i5 processor. So specifically, this is the Core i5-1035G1 from Intel's Ice Lake family. This CPU is built using Intel's latest 10 nanometer process technology. And this technology is actually at par with the 7 nanometer TSMC's node. So when you see an AMD processor on 7 nanometer, it's actually at par with Intel's 10 nanometer. It's just that these two companies have a different, way of measuring the channel length of the transistor. So Intel says 10 nanometer, TSMC says 7 nanometer, but it's basically the same. So this is a quad core processor with hyper threading enabled. This means that you get 8 execution threads, which is great for effortless multitasking. This CPU has a base clock frequency of 1 gigahertz and a max turbo frequency of 3.6 gigahertz. With these Ice Lake chips, Intel has dramatically improved the IPC. IPC is instructions per clock, and it represents the amount of work a CPU can do in one clock cycle. Ice Lake CPUs do more work at a low clock frequency than previous Intel chips, which means that this laptop delivers kick-ass performance while still preserving battery, so you get a good battery life and you get a good performance. Now, I have been very happy with the performance of this laptop in the last 6 months. While doing casual internet surfing, watching YouTube videos, and running productivity apps like Microsoft Office, this laptop has been running like a champ, and I'm very happy overall with what this laptop has been delivering. Now let's talk about the GPU. So HP Notebook 15 is using Intel's integrated UHD graphics. This is the Gen 11 graphics. This is a power efficient GPU suitable for casual gaming, multimedia playback, and light photo and video editing. I don't game on this laptop, but I did try Fortnite at 720p resolution and I got about 30 frames per second, so that was perfectly playable. This GPU supports hardware acceleration of all popular codecs. So codecs like H.264, AVC and VP9 are hardware accelerated, and so in simple English it just means that when you play 4K videos from YouTube or Netflix, you will have a smooth playback and there won't be any dropped frames. But guys, remember one thing, this is at the end of the day an integrated GPU. So don't expect NVIDIA or AMD discrete GPU class performance. If you plan to do hardcore gaming, then you are probably better off buying a gaming laptop. I have reviewed plenty of awesome gaming laptops here on this channel, and I will throw a link in the video description below if you want to check out these gaming laptops. Now let's talk about the system memory and the onboard SSD storage. So HP Notebook 15 comes with 8GB of system RAM and 256GB of fast PCIe NVMe SSD. Unfortunately, RAM is not user upgradable, which really sucks. But based on my last 6 months of using this laptop, I will say that the performance has been actually quite good even with the 8GB RAM. It always feels snappy while doing internet surfing using Chrome browser and running productivity apps like Microsoft Word and Excel sheet. Now, when it comes to expanding onboard SSD storage, HP Notebook 15 offers a second M.2 slot for adding another SSD. And I think this is really awesome because there are very few laptops in this price range which offer two M.2 SSD slots. So kudos to HP for doing that. So I went ahead and added a second SSD in my laptop and I have two SSD storage, and I really love the added benefit of having a fast SSD. Now, if you guys are interested in expanding storage, please check out the links of compatible PCIe NVMe SSD in the video description below. Okay, let's talk about the battery life, which is a super important feature for me. So HP Notebook 15 has a 3-cell 41 watt hour battery, which coupled with power efficient Ice Lake CPU gives fantastic battery life. I have been getting around 8 hours of battery life, doing lightweight web surfing, which means I don't need to worry about charging this laptop during daytime. Regarding the thermal heat dissipation, I'm very happy with this laptop. The onboard fan is very quiet and it does a very good job keeping this laptop cool. I think the power efficient 10 nanometer Ice Lake chip coupled with this really good heatsink pipe and fan assembly that HP has assembled, this laptop delivers very good thermals. Let's talk about the keyboard. It's a full-size island style keyboard with silver keys that nicely complement the overall aesthetics of this laptop. The keyboard island sits slightly lower than the palm rest, so this allows the keys to have a good travel distance while still not touching the screen when the laptop is closed. The keys are large in size, they are nicely balanced, and they are quite responsive. So I've been enjoying, typing on this laptop for the last 6 months. The keys have been offering a very nice tactile feedback and they never feel mushy. These keys stay very quiet during typing, which makes it an excellent laptop for students taking, notes in the classroom. Let's talk about the trackpad. So it's a fairly large trackpad measuring 4.5 by 2.5 inches. The trackpad is made from plastic, so you're not getting a glass trackpad, and that's not unusual for this price point, but it is a very clicky trackpad and it offers a smooth surface for executing all Windows 10 gestures. So stuff like pinch and zoom, double tap, two and three finger gestures, you can use all those gestures without any issues. So for me, after using this trackpad for 6 months, it does not feel wobbly and it still continues to perform as well as it did when, I got the laptop. So overall, I would say that both the keyboard and the trackpad, they are very durable and they should perform well for a long period of time. Okay, now let's talk about the webcam. This feature has been neglected by laptop makers for a very long time. But now in this age of, everybody working from home, webcam has become a very important feature when you're buying a laptop. Now, HP Notebook 15 comes with a 720p webcam and it also comes with a dual microphone setup. So I've used it for Zoom video calls and the video and audio quality is fine. Now, if you want to step up your video quality, check out my review of some 1080p external USB webcams. These are budget webcams. They all sell for under $50 and they dramatically improve the quality of video chats. because most of the laptops have 720p webcam. So when you jump to a 1080p webcam, your videos really look very good. And I will drop a link in the video description below of my video review, as well as links to some of my favorite 1080p USB webcams. Okay, moving on to the speakers. There are top firing stereo speakers, and they are really loud. So for a budget laptop, I was very impressed with the quality of these speakers. They definitely are louder than, you know, what you find in Acer Aspire 5 or some of these other like the Dell entry level laptop. This one is very loud. So kudos to HP for, you know, not skimping on the speakers. So if you're watching YouTube videos or Netflix, and if you don't feel like using headphones, you know, you can just use the speakers and it should be fine. Okay, now let's talk about the ports. So this laptop comes with plenty of ports, and I'm glad that HP has not cut any corners, you know, with the port selection. So you're getting a one USB 3.1 Gen 1 Type-C port, supporting data speeds up to 5 gigabits per second. Unfortunately, the USB Type-C port does not support power delivery. So that means you will still have to use your old brick to charge this laptop. You can't use the modern USB Type-C cable to charge the laptop. Now you also get two USB 3.1 Gen 1 Type-A port for connecting your, you know, traditional USB devices. And that includes your keyboard, mouse, you know, external hard drives and stuff like that. Now this laptop supports the latest Wi-Fi 6 standard, which will give you the fastest and the most robust wireless internet connection. By the way, you also get Bluetooth 5.0 standard support, which means, you know, your latest headphones, wireless headphones, they will work with this laptop, and you will get the advantage of, you know, the modern Bluetooth 5.0 headphones, which have extra features, including like support for multiple devices. So this laptop will play nicely with those headphones. You also get an HDMI port for hooking this laptop to an external monitor. And I was able to connect my laptop to my external 4K monitor, and I was able to create a nice dual screen setup. And this laptop had no trouble driving a 4K monitor. I think this will be really useful for folks working from home who would like to take advantage of, you know, dual screen setup to boost their productivity. By the way, HP Notebook 15 also comes with a full size SD card slot, which is great for folks like me who routinely need to transfer pictures and videos, you know, from their cameras. So overall, I think HP has all your bases covered when it comes to port selection. Okay, so after 6 months of daily use, what do I think of this laptop? So I think that for $599, HP has got a winner in their hands. You are getting the latest Intel CPU offering great performance and great battery life. You are getting a good quality 1080p screen, great keyboard, great trackpad, and you are getting plenty of ports. The only negative that I can think of is the lack of user upgradable RAM and a screen which, you know, could have been a little more brighter. You know what? HP should learn a thing or two from Acer Aspire laptop, because that laptop offers both RAM and SSD upgrade option. Now, if you are interested in checking out the Acer Aspire 5 laptop, I have put a link in the video description below. I've reviewed this laptop many times here on this channel, so please check out all my videos on this laptop. Okay guys, so I think I will wrap up this video. Let me know what you guys think of HP Notebook 15 as a mid-tier laptop, especially when you compare it with offerings from Asus, Acer and Dell. I hope you guys found this video useful. Please like this video and subscribe to TechnoPanda for more videos like this. Also check out technopandareviews.com for more reviews focusing on laptops and gaming PCs. Again guys, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.